Good morning.
Good morning.
It has been a difficult week. Whether you are here in person in our parking lot or on Zoom, whether you are here as a visitor or regular participant, it is good at such times to be together as people of faith, seeking to find what answers we can, but in any case, to be together in worship and in support of one another. Today we celebrate Reformation. Well done, all wearing red. It is good to see you. We also are celebrating our youth-led worship service and, of course, the confirmation of Brooklyn Locurto, who has put a number of years of hard work into this day. I believe we have a couple of congregational announcements.
Yes.
I'm here to tell you about a couple of projects that the congregation has. Time. I don't even know how to use one of these things. The first one is called Safe Space, and it is a warming center and a center for homeless people in Ellsworth. We started a year ago taking meals there once a month and thought we would sort of feel our way. Then the pastor who was leading us, Pastor Mull, many of you remember, was not able to make the trip over here all the time because of his illness. And so we're sort of in limbo with that, but we are not in limbo with the project that we said we would do, which was to gather used backpacks for these people, because most of them carry all their belongings with them in their backpacks. So if you have anything like that around home, that would be great. Even if it's something that is not a backpack particularly, but it has handles on it, that would do as well. So that's one thing. And there is a box for those in the narthex over by the wooden cabinet. In the wooden cabinet is our second project called Clink, and it is a wonderful project, really, because all we have to do is put our returnables, Coke bottles, whatever, all those things, check plastic things carefully to make sure that they are returnable, and then put them in to a garbage size bag like this. There is a tag that goes on the bag. The tag is so tiny you'll lose it probably the first time. I have extras, but it goes in a specific place on the bag, and then those can be returned to Hannaford. There's a whole space for it, a whole little building over as you approach over on the right. Some of you may know this. You're with me there, for those who don't. And I, by the way, will be putting this information in the newsletter or bulletin or something. So when we fold it all down, it looks like this. And right now, those are located in the wooden cabinet. And you maybe help yourself to these. Take that home and use it. And also, a thought is to get smaller bags, and if you're a walker, clean up the roadside as you're going along, wear a rubber glove or something, and pick those things up, and we can also clean up our environment as well as for our own use. Oh, and I wanted to mention that Dale is going to be putting up a small shelf in the fellowship hall, and these will be soon be out of the cabinet, so you don't have to go look for them there. But when you're back for coffee, or if you just want to go and pick those up, that would be great. They'll be there. And thanks for your support for this, because I think these are things that will help our community as well as us support.
Thank you, Lynn.
communication systems and has refused to comment. Restoration of cell service, but our team, like so many others, has...
Good morning. I don't know, people know who I am. I'm Dave Hacker, a new member here. And Esther Vogel immediately tried to find some work for us to do. So since my wife and I are avid amateur photographers, we've decided to take pictures to put into a photo album of members of the congregation. And we'll start next Sunday after church, and it'll be on the 5th, the 19th of November, and the 3rd of December. We will be here to take pictures. They won't be anything fancy, because this is the first time I've done this, done portrait stuff. So we will be playing it by ear, I think. And a lot of times we attend church here on Zoom. And so those people on Zoom, if you can't make it in, try and give us some kind of idea how we can include you in this process. Thank you.
Very good. Other announcements. I can't count the number of times I have heard, you know, it's so helpful to have a face to put with a name. And so with Dave's help, Dave and Artie's help, we are going to put out the first St. Andrew pictorial directory in quite a few years. I've also been asked to remind folks about the harvest meals. The sign-up sheet is in the narthex on the bulletin or in the easel there. Please do sign up if you would like to take a meal home. And thanks to our youth group and adults for the decorations that greeted us as we approached the church this morning. We had a wonderful day yesterday at our fall festival. As we also discussed yesterday at the men's prayer breakfast, it is hard to find answers to the events of this past week in Lewiston and elsewhere here in Maine. So today, during our prayers of the church, there will be an extended time of silence or an extended pause. We invite you here to lift up prayers either aloud or silently. God does hear all words spoken in his name. On Zoom, please do make use of chat or, again, silent prayer during that time. The other thing I would ask of us as a faith community is, many may remember that a little over 2 years ago, following the deaths of three members in our congregation and the invasion of Ukraine, we did a service of lament and reassurance. And so I'm not going to ask you to raise hands at this point, but think about whether that would be helpful for us as a community. Talk about it. Let me know, talk with Debbie. If we do feel we should do that, then Debbie and I and worship team will have some planning to do, but let us know if that would be a comfort and a help for you in this time. I think that's all the announcements I have for this morning. Just a reminder in addition that this coming Tuesday will be our second Bible and beverage gathering in the fellowship hall. And for those who choose on Zoom, the Zoom invitation was in last week's weekly update, 10 o'clock in the fellowship hall. And then next Sunday, please keep in your prayers. We will have our first weekly Sunday school session starting next Tuesday. And so let us take a moment to prepare ourselves for worship.
Thank you.
Will those who are able please rise? In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hid, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and of one another. Most merciful God, we confess that we are in bondage to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Almighty God, in his mercy, has given his Son to die for us, and for his sake, God forgives us all of our sins. As a called and ordained minister of the Church of Christ and by his authority, I therefore declare to you the entire forgiveness of all of your sins, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
This is the feast of victory for our God. Alleluia.
You. Almighty God, gracious Lord, we thank you that your Holy Spirit renews the church in every age. Pour out your Holy Spirit on your faithful people. Keep them steadfast in your word. Protect and comfort them in times of trial. Defend them against all enemies of the gospel. And bestow on the church your saving peace. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. The congregation may be seated.
Oh. Okay, we're good.
Okay.
A reading from Jeremiah. This is what the Lord said. The time is coming when I will make a new agreement with the family of Israel and with the family of Judah. It will not be like the agreement I made with their ancestors. I made that agreement when I took them by the hand and brought them out of Egypt. I was their master, but they broke that agreement. This message is from the Lord. In the future, I will make this agreement with the people of Israel. This message is from the Lord. I will put my teachings in their minds, and I will write them on their hearts. I will be their God, and they will be my people. People will not have to teach their neighbors and relatives to know the Lord, because all people, from the least important to the most important, will know me. This message is from the Lord. I will forgive them for the evil things they did. I will not remember their sins. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The second reading is from Romans chapter 3, verses 19 to 28. Now we know that whatever the law says, it speaks to those who are under the law, so that every mouth may be silenced, and that the whole world may be held accountable to God. For no human being will be justified in his sight by deeds prescribed by the law, for through the law comes the knowledge of sin. But now, apart from the law, the righteousness of God has been disclosed, and is attested by the law and the prophets, the righteousness of God through faith in Jesus Christ for all who believe. For there is no distinction, since all have sinned and fall short of glory of God. They are now justified by his grace as a gift through the redemption that is in Christ Jesus, whom God put forward as a sacrifice of atonement by his blood, effective through faith. He did this to show his righteousness, because in his divine forbearance he has passed over the sins previously committed. It was to prove at the present time that he himself is righteous, and that he justifies the one who has faith in Jesus. Then what becomes the boasting? It is excluded. By what law? By that of his works? No, but by the law of faith. For we hold that a person is justified by faith apart from works prescribed by the law. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Gospel reading for this Reformation Sunday is from the 8th chapter of John.
Glory to you, O God.
Jesus said to the Jews who had believed in him, "If you continue in my word, you are truly my disciples, and you will know the truth, and the truth will make you free." They answered him, "We are descendants of Abraham and have never been slaves to anyone. What do you mean by saying, 'You will be made free'?" Jesus answered them, "Very truly I tell you, whoever commits sin is a slave to sin. The slave does not have a permanent place in the household. The son has a place there forever. So if the Son makes you free, you will be free indeed. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Please be seated. Grace and peace be with you through the power of the Holy Spirit, from God our Father and from our Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. We have before us today, if not the foundation of the Reformation, at least one of its major underpinnings. Romans chapter 3, verse 21, two words. But now. It was this passage which became the breakthrough to understanding for Martin Luther. It was this passage which brought about a renewed understanding of God's love and purpose for all of humanity. So, a different question for you. How many of you remember erector sets? Oh, wonderful. I loved my erector set growing up. For those of you who don't know, they were little build-it sets consisting of metal girders and brackets and plastic wheels and bars and all kinds of amazing stuff that you could put together with teeny tiny little nuts and bolts. You could make amazing contraptions with erector sets. Well, one evening, my brother and I were playing downstairs and I discovered a really cool thing. You could take one of the erector set axles, slip it inside one of the erector set plastic tubes, and with a flick of the wrist, create a little erector set weapon of minor destruction. If you shot that axle hard enough, you could get it to stick into the wall. It was great. Unfortunately, the accuracy wasn't too good. No, I didn't puncture my older brother, but I did end up shattering an antique mirror that my parents had received just a month or so before, following the death of an extended family member. My brother and I sat there stunned. After we finished listening to the sound of glass falling, we started listening for the sound of parents coming. Thankfully, they didn't seem to have heard. Our next step was to discuss how to tell them, or maybe not. Now, our parents had told my brother and me on numerous occasions that as long as you tell us the truth, we will understand. Yeah, right. You'll understand me right into my room for the next week. There had to be a better way. A way to avoid the consequences of my actions. My brother and I spent quite a bit of time trying to figure out how to hide the mirror. Maybe Mom and Dad wouldn't notice the really big mirror in the huge frame that had hung for years in Grandpa Vogel's house and was now in pieces. Kids have great imaginations, don't they? Finally, we agreed I would tell them. When I got to confession time, I admit I juiced it up a bit. Really laid it on about, I didn't realize the axle would fly that far, and I had thought about not telling them or coming up with some story, but decided the only thing I could do was to tell them the truth. You know, going for that, well, he told us the truth, so we can't really punish him angle. I may have glossed over the 27 other times I shot the axle across the room. At the time, I thought I had gotten the best of my parents. All I ended up was a bit of a lecture, no other punishment at all. Jesus tells us that all the commandments can be summed up in two sentences. Love the Lord your God with all your heart and mind, and love your neighbor as yourself. Children of God of any age have great imaginations at times. We think we can hide the self-centeredness which motivates us so often. We think we can hide our failure to live faithful lives behind justifications and excuses. We can't. We certainly can't hide it from God. But we can't even hide it from those around us. When we hold anger and bitter thoughts toward another person, rather than seeking to forgive or to understand, those thoughts come through in division and in injury to others and ourselves. When we place our own desires ahead of God's desires and plans for us, we shatter the unity that God wants for us, for our congregation, for our community, nation, and world. Sometimes, like my brother and I, we simply try to avoid the consequences, as if by not getting caught, the mirror wouldn't have been broken. But now. Although I didn't understand it at the time, the mirror really wasn't the issue. The issue for me and for my parents was my actions. Actions which put myself and others, in this case my older brother, in danger. The issue was that I hadn't been thinking through what might happen when I acted without understanding or thought for others. Actions not simply of breaking a rule or a commandment, consequences of not simply avoiding punishment, but doing things which put myself and others at risk. My parents' desire was never to punish my brother and me. Just as God's desire, God whose love for us is infinitely deeper and wiser than the most caring mother or father. God doesn't desire our punishment. God's desire is that you and I and our neighbors have life and have it in abundance. Certainly, the events of this past week demonstrate the brokenness of God's creation. The shooting in Lewiston, on top of the fighting in Jerusalem and Gaza, all while death and suffering in Ukraine continues. Perhaps for you, this brings about anger at God, questioning if God is all-powerful, how can he claim to be at work in our world? Or if God is so involved, then he must be incapable of preventing so much grief. I have felt that anger at God many times. At other times, my anger is toward humanity, whom God has blessed so richly with abilities and skills. And yet we don't use those gifts to prevent the suffering of others, much less when we use them to outright cause that suffering. My journey of seeking to understand both why a loving God allows such suffering of his children and why humanity is so ready to cause that suffering continues. I don't have the answers to either. I do believe that it is up to us as a faith community to continue to struggle with these questions. Because I know that trying to do so in isolation can only lead to despair. It is right and proper that we, as pastor and congregation, address the events of this past week. But we err if we allow grief, however great, to steal away our joy in other things. Today, we celebrate the affirmation of faith of Brooklyn Locurto, a young woman who has been taught about God's love and promise for her, not just by her parents and family, but also through being a part of this community of faith that is St. Andrew, of seeing your care and your faithfulness through the years. Brooklyn, I rejoice in your standing before our congregation this morning, this community of the faithful, which cherishes you and is so deeply proud of you. I pray that you will remember today and through all the years of your life ahead that God's way and the way of the church, or at least the way the church should be, is not the way of the world. For this world, whether it is proclaiming extravagance or despair, seeks always to deceive you and to separate you from God who gave you life. You, together with your sisters and brothers in Christ across all time and space, all human boundaries, are and always will be in God's care and keeping. Wherever your life may take you, during all the years you will experience ahead, either of success or failure, joys or struggles, God will be with you. And there will always be available to you sisters and brothers in Christ to support you, to comfort you, and to cheer you on in your journey. Following Christ has never meant a life of ease or comfort, much less of knowing all the answers. It does mean that we face those struggles or celebrate those victories in the company of saints and sinners redeemed by Christ's victory over sin and death. Amen. Congregation may be seated. Dear friends, we give thanks for the gift of baptism and for, I missed the Edith part. Is that middle name? Oh, okay. That's not a typo. For Brooklyn Edith Locurto. One with us in the body of Christ who is making public affirmation of her baptism. Let us pray. Merciful God, we thank you for Brooklyn, whom you have made your own by water and the word in baptism. You have called her yourself, enlightened her with the gifts of your Spirit, and nourished her in this community of faith. Uphold Brooklyn in the gifts and promises of baptism, and unite the hearts of all whom you have brought to new birth. We ask this in the name of Christ.
Amen.
Brooklyn, I ask you to profess your faith in Christ Jesus, reject sin, and confess the faith of the Church. Do you renounce the devil and all the forces that defy God, the powers of this world that rebel against God, and the ways of sin that draw you from God?
I renounce them.
The congregation may join with Brooklyn. Do you believe in God the Father?
I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth.
Do you believe in Jesus Christ, the Son of God?
I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. Do you believe in God the Holy Spirit?
I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Brooklyn, you have made public profession of your faith. Do you intend to continue in the covenant God made with you in holy baptism, to live among God's faithful people, to hear the word of God and share in the Lord's Supper, to proclaim the good news of God in Christ through word and deed, to serve all people following the example of Jesus, and to strive for justice and peace in all the earth? Of the congregation, those who are able, please rise. People of God, do you promise to support Brooklyn and to pray for her in her life in Christ?
We do, and we ask God to help and guide us.
Let us pray. Kneel. Be comfortable kneeling. Be comfortable kneeling right there. Let us pray. We give you thanks, O God, that through water and the Holy Spirit you give us new birth, cleanse us from sin, and raise us up to eternal life. Stir up in Brooklyn the gift of your Holy Spirit, the Spirit of wisdom and understanding, the Spirit of counsel and might, the Spirit of knowledge and the fear of the Lord, the Spirit of joy in your presence, both now and forever.
Amen.
Okay. Turn and face the congregation.
Let us rejoice with Brooklyn, our sister in Christ.
We rejoice
with you in the life of baptism. Together we will give thanks and praise to God and proclaim the good news to all the world. Let us. Good job. In Brooklyn, I do have a confirmation certificate for you and no ink in the printer, so that will be coming. Trusting in the transformative power of God's loving Spirit, let us pray for the Church, the world, and all in need. Holy God, you give the law that your people live by it and flourish. Write your law on the hearts of all who bear your name, and teach us to love your commandments, that we live as you intend. God of grace, Holy God, you plant the earth and water it and bring forth a fruitful harvest. Send favorable weather, just wages, and the bounty of your abundance to all who are engaged in the labor of harvest. God of grace, Holy God, you watch over the ways of the righteous and judge your people with fairness. Guide judges, courts, elected officials, and all those tasked with upholding the law, inspiring them with your wisdom and zeal for justice. Pour out your abundant mercy and protection to those whose lives are being torn apart, here and in so many places across our world. We ask for your power at work, for those who are under assault or being forced into violence beyond their nature, in particular the people of Ukraine, Jerusalem and Gaza, and the families in Lewiston and elsewhere in our nation. God of grace, Holy God, you hold your people in love and surround them with your mercy. Draw near to all who are in need. In this time and place, we lift before you what our hearts call us to say, aloud or silently or by chat.
For a broken world.
God of grace, Holy God, you call us to love one another as we love ourselves. Give us the will and patience to love those who are difficult to love. Bless all the ministries of this congregation through which we show love for our neighbors. God of grace, Holy God, you have broken the chains of death and daily make all things new. We give you thanks for the witness of reformers like Martin Luther and all the saints. We pray that your transformative spirit is at work in us. God of grace, gracious God, into your hands we commend all for whom we pray, trusting in your unending love and amazing grace, through Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
And now the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And also with you.
Share a sign of God's peace with one another, with horns in our parking lot and with chat on Zoom.
Peace, everybody.
Peace, everybody. Peace, Mary.
Peace, Bonnie.
Peace, Art and Lee. And Irwin and Crystal.
Peace, Irwin and Crystal. And
peace,
Sim. You can all unmute yourselves.
Peace, Janet and Betsy. peace in this world. Peace.
Well, so I have to do that, huh, Mary? Peace to everybody.
Peace.
Remind people
peace
to unmute themselves.
Peace,
Tim.
Peace to you, Bonnie.
Peace.
Knows I have the ability to unmute people.
And Gregor, too. Peace, Mary.
We continue with the offering.
Let us pray. God of power, God of plenty, all things belong to you. We bring your gifts to the table that all might be fed. Form us into the body of your beloved Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
Let
us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is indeed right and salutary that we should at all times and in all places offer thanks and praise to you, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and ever-living God. You comforted your people with the promise of the Redeemer, through whom you will also make all things new, in the day when he comes again to judge the world in righteousness. And so with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Blessed are you, Lord of heaven and earth. In mercy for our fallen world, you gave your only Son, that all those who believe in him should not perish, but have eternal life. We give thanks to you for the salvation you have prepared for us through Jesus Christ. Send now your Holy Spirit into our hearts, that we may receive our Lord with a living faith, as he comes to us in his Holy Supper.
Amen. Come, Lord Jesus.
In the night in which he was betrayed, our Lord Jesus took bread and gave thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take and eat. This is my body given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." Again, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it for all to drink, saying, "This cup is the new covenant in my blood, shed for you and for all people for the forgiveness of sin. Do this for the remembrance of me."
Amen.
Lord, remember us in your kingdom and teach us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Jesus invites you to this table. Come, eat, and live. You may be seated. In our parking lot and on Zoom, receive the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ, broken and shed for you.
Amen.
Thank you. Those who are able, please rise. Now the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace.
Amen.
Let us pray. Blessed be your name, O God, for we have feasted on your word, Christ Jesus, the joy and delight of our hearts. Strengthened by this food, send us to gather the world to your banquet, where none are left out and all are satisfied. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Following our closing hymn and dismissal, all are invited to continue to celebrate together and to share our thanks with Brooklyn as much as she's able to stand this morning. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Peace. God is at work in you.
Thanks be to God.